Hi, I'm Brian English, Wappler forum name Hyperbytes, and in this module I'm going to show you how to install Wappler onto a new machine. So I've already downloaded the Wappler application, which you can do from the website, whether you're downloading your 14-day trial or indeed you've jumped straight in and done the exciting thing of subscribing straight away. So I've downloaded it, here we are, it's on our desktop, and it's a really simple install. We're just going to double click that, off we go. This may be a little bit slow, just basically because I'm running this in a Windows Hyper-V session, just so you can see what happens when you're doing a first time install. Obviously I didn't want to clear my development system to highlight what happens here, so it's going to be a little bit slow, so I will pause the video from time to time just to stop you having to look at a slow moving progress bar through this. So see you in a second. And at the end of this install, you'll see there we have the opportunity to start Wappler automatically when we click the finish button. So we need to log in now. So we have to log in with our browser. And that will bring it to the email address. I'm just going to pause the video. And once you have submitted your email address, you will then retrieve a code from an email that will be sent to that email address. So again, if you just give me one moment. And now I'm going to enter the code that has just been sent in the email. It will then ask you if it can open Wappler, and obviously you're going to allow that. Just close that web browser now because we don't need it at all. And now we'll wait for Wappler to open. So as Wappler opens now, it gives us the opportunity to create a new project, clone an existing project, or open a Wappler project file. For the moment, I'm just going to do the very simple thing. I'm going to open a demo project just so that you can see what happens when we do that. And there we are, we have Wappler opening. May well get a request to allow Wappler to communicate through your firewall. Obviously that is essential. Now we can see that we have our project open, and if we just double click on that, we see that we have our first page shown within Wappler. So that's fairly straightforward. There are a few more things that I'm going to be showing you now in terms of installing the dependencies. Okay, so now what we're going to do is just check that everything that the system requires is installed. Very simple, we just go down to the corner here and hit system check. We click here, we can also open a, do you want to install a scoop installer for Windows? Yes. If we just click here, we'll see that we will open a terminal window. So we can see the output, and we can see now that Wappler is installing Scoop. For those who don't know what that is, it's effectively an auto installer that can be used within Wappler to install the various dependencies that are required. Once Scoop has finished installing, then we will we'll see the other dependency. I'm just going to do a brief pause here. See now that Scoop is now installing 7-zip as well, which again is required by Wappler as a dependency. And now we're installing a portable version of Git, because Wappler does support Git local and remote deployment. Against more updates being installed. And beauty of this is totally automated, albeit I must add the proviso there that in the future some of these installs might be removed as an auto install and become a manual install, for which Wappler team will obviously provide instructions. And that's due to the fact that the software itself often changes its own setup, which sort of breaks the auto install. So we'll be covering the manual install as well. I'm just going to rerun that system check, because it does seem to be something missing. If it's missing, just reinstall again. You'll see now it's actually installing Node.js, which is required not only for node sites obviously, but is used internally with it with Wappler, I understand. I think I'll just pause this video again for a short second, and now we see that node has been successfully installed. That appears to be in the end of the stall, so I'll just do system check once more and just make sure that everything is installed. Obviously there was a problem with the Node.js install. Successful. So I think at this stage, because there's been so much change, I'm actually going to close Wappler. You'll notice here also that Wappler has a tray icon. I'm just going to quit that as well, and then I'm going to reopen it. And that's just to make sure that everything that needs to be installed is installed and properly initialized. And now you see everything checks out perfectly with the system check. So all that was the problem there, that little error message saying not installed properly, was basically just Wappler needed a restart to be able to install that software properly. So there we are, now we've installed the necessary dependencies that are required for Wappler, albeit I will be doing a couple more modules to show you how to install Node.js outside of the Windows environment. And also when we come to the deployment side of things, I'll be showing you how to manually install Docker Desktop. Thanks for listening.